This Pegasus lecture's quick concept is on the differences between acrania and anencephaly. This image demonstrates the echogenic ribs, anechoic heart chambers, and the thorax and abdominal tissues. We see the ribs right here, and the heart, and then the thoracic tissues right in through here. The fetal brain tissues are visualized. The fetal brain is visualized, but the skull is not seen. Here we see the brain tissues. This is an image demonstrating acrania. Acrania is a rare, lethal disorder where the skull is completely or partially absent, but the brain tissues remain. The abnormally but large brain is visualized with acrania. The fetus cannot survive with acrania. The fetus may miscarry before reaching term. Anencephaly is another lethal congenital fetal brain disorder where, in addition to no skull, there is no brain tissue. In this image, we see part of a fetal femur, we're seeing part of the diaphragm, we're seeing some of the fetal facial features, such as the orbits, but we're not seeing the skull and we're not seeing the brain. Therefore, this image demonstrates anencephaly. Anencephaly may be seen late in the first trimester. It is a severe, lethal, and fairly common type of neural tube defect that is caused by the failure of the neural tube to close. Anencephaly is the absence of the cranial vault and the brain tissue. With anencephaly, the brain stem, base of the skull, and orbits are usually present. On ultrasound, anencephaly presents with visible facial features, but no skull is seen, as is the case on this image. Some of the symptoms you might encounter with anencephaly include polyhydramnios after 25 weeks because the fetus lacks the swallowing mechanisms. You may also see absence of the cranium above the orbits, bulging fetal orbits due to the absent frontal bone. This happens to give the fetus a more of a frog-like type of appearance. You may also see increased fetal activity due to the irritative effects of exposed meninges and neural tissue. Distinguishing between acrania and anencephaly is important as the risks of reoccurrence with acrania is very low, while with anencephaly, recurrence of neural tube defects may occur. This Pegasus lecture's quick concept was on the differences between acrania and anencephaly.